So the banks, although they look like they're increasing their profits, when you look at it, they aren't. And they have a point to make when they say their overseas funding costs are very high and they can't afford to pass on these official cash rate cuts.
And yet that listener story seemed to highlight behaviours, new behaviours by the banks that seem to go beyond that. Companies who've been customers in good standing for, in some cases, decades, finding it difficult to get the kind of short-term credit that those businesses need to keep going. There's a real risk here, I think, isn't there?
Essentially, when you borrow from a bank, they control you. That's the fact of it. And you've got to look too at how easy things became in the last 4 or 5 years for many businesses, and that they could borrow whenever they wanted at reasonably easy covenants. And now the banks are understandably tightening up. Now, some would say they're tightening up too much, particularly for some small to medium businesses, and even for some large ones. But New Zealanders should, I think, really understand and thank the banks for not getting involved in the crazy stuff which has killed off many of the biggest banks in America and in Europe, and they're still not out of the woods yet. New Zealanders, I don't think, appreciate how desperate the situation is for many businesses in the UK and the US, where their banks literally have pulled their funding completely. The sort of grief we're seeing here is nothing like the grief people are seeing in the US.
So it could be worse.
Much worse.
Now, Tim, our banks haven't had the big bailouts, but they did get the government guarantee scheme. And something I'm seeing more often in the news now is the idea that there is some corresponding public obligation for them having accepted that guarantee scheme. Do you think there's something in there? And what would that obligation be?
I think there is something in that, but to balance that point, I think it's worth remembering that the purpose of the guarantee was really not so much to protect the banks, it was to protect the banks' customers. So the people who are really benefiting from that are depositors of the banks. And certainly it is a benefit to the banks that it stopped a run on funds. And I think, balancing that, I think there is a, they do, they should feel obliged to look after New Zealanders as a consequence of that.
Andrew, you've taken quite a different view there. You believe that there is something incumbent on the banks for having accepted that guarantee, don't you?
Yeah. I mean, it comes back to our general point, which is that we think everyone needs to pitch in whichever way they can in order for us all to get out of the recession. And looking at the banks, they are in a strong position to be able to do that. And so part of the reason we think that there is a good reason to put some conditions on those guarantees is that whilst the banks are still profitable, they can keep people in work, so rather than adding to unemployment, that's an obvious condition. That's what we presented to Parliament yesterday.
But isn't this a slippery slope? Once you start imposing that condition, why don't you say, well, you have to charge this interest rate and you have to reduce those fees? Once you get government in there and telling banks what they can and can't do, don't you risk sliding back into the sort of mid-'80s Muldoonism that made our banking system so poor back then?
Yeah, but otherwise you risk sliding back into the mid-'90s or early 2000s boom-bust optimism, which actually made a lot of those other banks fall over. I mean, one of the things that has happened as a result of the guarantees is that they're returning similar levels of very large profits back to their Australian shareholders. That's income lost to New Zealand.
You find that many of those profits are actually being reinvested in New Zealand. They're not being sent back to Australia.
There's a lot that is not, and the government and the taxpayer is underwriting that.
But aren't the banks?
But the reality is, if I can just make this one point, is that the argument that they should just be standalone businesses who should be allowed to do business as usual ignores the fact that them and their contemporaries created the current crisis. And whilst the banks in New Zealand and Australia may not be as much to blame, they are part of a global financial system which needs to clean its act up. And I don't think that there is many New Zealanders who would be looking at them going, "Oh, actually, keep your $3 billion combined profit, do what you like with it, don't have a part to play in the recovery here, you just go off and do what you like."
And you sought to quantify that with another clever way of getting yourself in the news, I must say. You commissioned a poll.
Yeah.
What was the question in that poll?
Well, the question we wrote got rejected by UMR. They said it was too leading. So they actually reworked the question, and they came up with a question which was, I can't remember exactly, but basically is, in exchange for receiving government support through these guarantee schemes, do you think that the banks should have an obligation to keep people in employment? And people overwhelmingly said yes to that.
What concerns me about this is that we have a news agenda now, which is being set by companies, unions, others, who drive the agenda with pre-cooked stories. And these polls are what I see as a pre-cooked story. My big concern here is that the mainstream media, I'm talking mostly about newspapers and television and radio, simply do not have the expertise in the journalism staff. I accept the Sunday Star Times, which is doing a fantastic job, by the way, but the rest do not have the expertise to pull some of this stuff apart and to ask the tough questions, not just of the banks, but of the unions and those people who are arguing their case.
Right, we're going to have to come back to that because we're taking a break now. And when we come back, a look at how banks have sold themselves to us. Evelyn. Welcome back to Media 7, where I'm talking about the way banks fare in the media with Tim Hunter, Andrew Campbell and Bernard Hickey. In this week's Take 2, Sarah Daniel looks at the ways that banks have sought our good opinion.
Banks and finance companies, they're all over the TV news like a rash.
Nah, mere details.
Not always in the news, but sponsoring the news. There's the one with the black horse. ASB.
Live long and prosper, sir.
ASB Business. TSB. Kiwi Bank.
Let's go get it!
Before the storm clouds gathered, even the weather was sponsored by a finance company.
This one weather update is brought to you by Hanover Finance.
Here's Richard Long.
A company built on many years of experience.
Now, how many people put their trust in Long before they put their hard-earned savings into this finance company?
It'll blow you away!
Here's Current Affairs brought to you by a finance company. Banks and finance companies like getting into bed with news journalists too. Here's Ian Fraser.
A question of money.
Actually, Ian, it's a question of credibility. We borrow from the banks, and the banks in turn borrow credibility from the news. No one ever tells lies in this time slot.
Because today's big interest is in peace of mind.
This thoroughbred has not yet crapped in the living room, but in the case of the finance companies, the horse bolted, and the punter's hard-earned money went down the dunny.
There's quite enough mischief for today.
Sarah Daniel there. Well, Tim, were you watching that wishing you had a sponsor for your business section?
Certainly not. I find it incredible that a news bulletin would seek sponsorship from any organisation, let alone one that they're likely to be required to report on objectively. And I think it's a sign, perhaps significant, that you know, you can't imagine something like the Sunday Star Times or the New Zealand Herald brought to you by ASB. I mean, that would be absurd, wouldn't it?
So although I must say the Herald website was brought to you by Vodafone a few weeks ago. So.
Well, maybe I'm not up to date on that, but I